Hey everybody, welcome back to another episode of Jennifer's Lair. If you hear some rain in the background, it's pouring out there tonight. We're under a flood advisory, so hopefully we don't float away, lol. Also, you might hear some thunder and see some lightning in this video, so just so you know, it is thundering and lightning as well as it's pouring rain, which is so awesome because I want to thank Mother Nature for all of the natural sound effects we have tonight. Today, I thought we would go through, well, I should say tonight, I wanted to show you some tarot decks and some oracle cards and kind of explain what the difference between tarot cards and oracle cards are, because sometimes people wonder. And so I thought maybe I would just do a little research and put some knowledge on the subjects. So here we go. And we also have cuties in the room. Charm, Mooney, Punky, and Raven, our four cats, are in my room right now. So, and a lot of them are chilling, but Charmy's up wandering around. So I wonder if she's going to get restless and try to come up here. But I have a lot of stacks of my tarot cards and my oracle cards in piles here. And I have a stack here. But first, we'll go through some stuff. I'm going to read some of the information that I found. I like to read information to you guys because it's important to get the information right. This is stuff that I did research on, so, and I'm hoping that it's correct, that I've, you know, because I try to give out, you know, accurate information so nobody can say, well, you know, you were wrong about this and that. I don't want to give out wrong information. If I do, it's my mistake. I'm not perfect, so I will apologize for it and we'll move on. This article, or these, like, information that I got was from Elite, Goddess Elite. And I guess, I don't know, it must be, like, a place that sells cards and things like that. I'm not real sure, but this is where I'm getting my information from. And I also got some from Siri, too, so. But, here's the information I got from Elite, Goddess Elite. Tarot and oracle cards, what's the difference? With a growing number of new tarot and oracle cards coming out, we thought we'd dive into a simple guide as to the difference between these two different tools. This post will help you understand the differences so you can choose the right deck for your spiritual journey. Differences between tarot and oracle cards. Tarot mainly covers the emotions and why we do things, motivations, psychological reasoning, and feelings, moods. The art of tarot reading has ancient roots in divination. It is the most common fortune-telling tool out there. Tarot has 78 cards. Major arcana, I'm sorry, I'm butchering that, 22 cards, and minor arcana, 56 cards. The minor cards are divided into four elemental suits. Pentacles, which is earth, swords, that's air, wands, that's fire, and cups is water. With the ace through 10 being the pip cards, and page, knight, queen, and king being the court cards. Tarot structure and reading styles. The structure of the tarot is predictable. While cards may vary depending on which deck you use, example, in some decks, cups will be Chronicles and swords will be arrows, and some decks have prince, princess, queen, and kings as the court cards. An accomplished and talented tarot reader can read into the cards how you will respond. Traditionally, tarot are read as singular cards, although it is always the job of a reader to see how the cards surrounding with affect will affect each other, each positioning in a reading. It is a reader's choice as to how they read and interpret the cards. Some may only use major arcana, while others use the major cards to see a karmic path in a full deck reading. And still other readers may take into consideration reversible meanings of the cards. Oracle decks. Okay, so we're moving into oracles. Sorry if I butchered some of the words or whatever, but just kind of tired. It's late at night. This is my third video tonight. I'm trying to push through, so bear with me. I'm enjoying these videos, trust me. I'm just a little bit kind of on the tired side, if you see what I mean. Oh, whoops. And I accidentally kicked you. Sorry, guys. Sorry. Oracle. Oracle decks offer guidance, clarity into situation, and even a new perspective. This style of cards can have a variety of themes, from anything like the law of attraction and affirmations to the dark side or the dark night of the soul and shadow self. The number of cards in a deck also varies, as this isn't a set in stone style like the tarot. Oracle structure and reading styles. There are a variety of ways to read oracle cards, from single card draws to full life reading. Some readers use oracle cards to enhance, visualize more into a tarot reading, as interpretations are vastly different from a typical tarot deck. Oracle decks tend to be more open and flowing in their interpretations. They are much easier to read, to learn, and interpret, even with the specialty decks. Again, some readers may use an oracle deck in addition to a tarot and other divination to give a deep perspective into a reading. And here's another question you may have that I'm going to answer here. It's, okay, wait a minute. Okay. I thought there was more to read on the top of the page, but there isn't. Here's another question that you may be wanting to know. Which is better, tarot or oracle? Neither. It all depends on what feels best for the reader. Some people may feel a call to a certain deck, whether it is a tarot or oracle. Always go with your gut feeling when choosing a deck to learn and read with, as that will most likely work best for you. Try to incorporate both styles into your readings and see what happens. And then I did ask Siri about the question, what's the difference between oracle cards and tarot cards? The oracle decks or cards have any number of cards per deck, unlike tarot cards, which have 78 cards, are organized in different suits, and are designed around a theme. So there you go with that. That's just a little bit of knowledge we're touching up on today for the... Ooh, thank you. Thanks, Mother Nature, for that. Sometimes I wish that she would have kicked in more during the ghost stories. Okay, guys. So, we have got a lot of decks. I'm going to show you some of these decks and tell you my feelings on the decks. Because some of them I'm like more drawn to than others that I've picked out. Now, these are all decks that I've gotten like in stores or online or whatever. And some of them you may have seen in some of my witchy hauls. If you haven't, go back and check out some of these witchy hauls, because I'm sure there's some of these decks are going to show up in these. And some of them you have never seen before, because I've never shown them to you. So... But I'm going to start out with one of my favorite decks that I have loved. This is a tarot deck, by the way. I've got tarot and oracle cards that we're going to go through. This one in particular, I love this deck. And I've done readings with this animal deck. It's called the Animal Wisdom Tarot, and it's a really good little deck. And you can see the little spine. It comes in a little box which opens like this. And I did get this one a while back. I got it through, I believe it was Amazon or eBay. I can't remember which. But it was brand new. The plastic was still on. I opened it. So basically what the back of this says is body, mind, spirit. The Animal Wisdom Tarot blends traditional tarot symbolism with animal wisdom. The box contains a complete deck of 78 specially designed tarot cards and an accompanying 96-page book which explains how to use the cards and their meanings. Using tarot cards is a time-honored way to recognize patterns of our past, explore alterations in our present, and predict potential outcomes in our future. Every card in the deck features a unique animal drawing that merges classic tarot meaning with animal teaching and guidance. So, and this is one of my favorites. And so, okay, when you open it up, the cards are right here, and then you've got the book. And I'm going to show you some fun things with this book here. I'm hoping that they won't fall out. Here's the book that comes with the tarot cards. And here's the back of the book. Here's the little spine. I really like this. Because it's got so much information and pictures in this book. And it basically tells, like, it says the Animal Wisdom Tarot cards. And then you've got, like, different things that you can do with the cards. And it also explains what is tarot, the Animal Wisdom Tarot. It explains all this in great detail. And let's see. And it's got, like, all of the different types of suits. There's four suits, and it tells, like, what they are and what colors and what element they are when you draw them. And then there's also numbers. It explains, like, the numbers and stuff like that, how to read the tarot cards, the basics. And it also gives you different spreads to try. So there's one that's called past, present, and future. And of course, it's like three cards. The number one would be the present, and you would put that in the middle. The second one goes out on this side. And then the third one goes on the other side of the... but the second one would be the past, and the third one's the immediate future. Then you have a bear paws one. And so it tells you different little things that you can try. Like this one here has got, I believe it's six cards, right? Yeah, this is like a six card spread. This is the three one that I just read to you. Three card spread. Here's a honeybee lover spread, which that one's kind of fun to do. I think I've done that quite a few times. And the Celtic Cross one, I don't remember if I did this one or not, but it looks like familiar, like I have. I haven't done these tarot cards in a while, so I would like to do some more. I'd like to get into it more. And so this is kind of like a refresher course for me too, because I've kept them in a drawer and I haven't gotten them out lately. And I've felt like I've wanted to, but I just been kind of lazy, you know, I get lazy, or else I'm just like kind of trying to do, like, I've been doing like a lot of research on the ghost stories. I'm also trying at the moment, trying to find some movie, some new movies to try and watch when my mother-in-law comes over, because we're doing like movie nights. We just got done doing one last night. We watched Elvira, Rose Red, Stephen King's Rose Red, which was really good. And then we watched Elvira and Practical Magic. Actually, Practical Magic was after Rose Red, and then we watched Elvira. And then we ended up watching the new, the old Charmed with Shannon Doherty and Honey, or what was her name? Holly Combs, and then Alyssa Milano's in that one. So we watched that one, which I love because Prue, which is Shannon Doherty's character, is my favorite because I love Shannon Doherty. So, okay, so it basically tells you like different things about the card. Like if you draw the cat, for instance, they have a picture of the cat and it tells like, you know, the cat's knower of secrets, and the numbers, and then it tells like it's like card 2, the High Priestess, keynote, mystery, knowledge, awareness, and intuition. Then it goes on and tells about certain things about the card and stuff like that. So it's really detailed. And they do this for every animal that you may draw. And the book is color coordinated too. See, like you can see that there's like colors, different colors on the top of the pages. That's because there's certain colors for certain things. And like the cat was like a purple. And there's a blue one for like, I think this is like the water creatures, like sea. And they're doing like for fire, they do like the orange. And then they do like the yellow for, I want to say this might be earth maybe. No, that's air. They're doing yellow for air. And so they've got it kind of color coordinated for you and stuff. So it's kind of cool. And yeah, this is fire. And then they have the other one for, what is this one exactly? It doesn't tell me the element here. What the heck? Because it's a traditional, and then it's like got a keynote to it. Huh. I may have to look some stuff up later on that issue, but, and as of why they're not telling me that. But this is actually one of my favorite tarot decks, and it's one that I've used the most, and I'm drawn to this one. And so, And so, you know, look at what you want. Like, if you go to a store or whatever, and I'm not sure, like, if Barnes & Nobles has a bunch of these tarot decks. I don't know what they carry for that, because I never went there for tarot decks before. But, like, you can go to a witchy store and then, like, feel around and see what calls to you. Excuse me. And then pick up some decks that way. Because that's kind of how I usually do it. But this next deck I'm going to show you was given to me, and so I'm going to put this away first before I get into the other one, because I don't want to lose my cards. There we go. So this was the very first deck, and this one I really recommend if you love animals and stuff like this. This is a neat deck to try. So, and it, like I said, it comes with the book, so it'll help you read the cards and everything and stuff like that. So this one's a very good, thorough deck to own. And like I said, it was one of my first ones. Whoops. And I just dropped my hair thing on the floor, and I really don't care because it's a hair clip. It'll survive. This one here was given to me by my husband, and it's still in the wrapping. I haven't tried it yet. But he got it in a grab box from Christie's Crystals. Now, I don't remember if one of my hauls from Christie's Crystals, I think it got like completely scrapped or something. I don't really know what happened to it. But so you might not have seen this, but you might have. And so this one here was a gift from my husband because he got it in one of those grab boxes that she has at Christie's Crystals, which is really fun. I haven't opened it yet. I don't know exactly what to expect with this deck. So I'm not sure. So this will be one that I'm gonna try to use, you know, and see what happens with it. Okay, and so, whoops, I am moving the camera because it's really close to me right now. Oh, my nose is itchy. This is a book that I got. I believe this came from Spencer's Gifts or whatever. They did have some crystals by it or whatever, and it does, it's a the Tarot Companion, a portable guide to reading the cards for yourself and others. So this book has like a lot of different things. So if you're like wondering about tarot and you want to learn some stuff, and I mean, all the books that come with the tarot cards, I think it does have a lot of the same things as this book does, sadly, but it does have like some other information in here that I thought maybe I would share. There's an introduction to the tarot, and then there's card interpretations, and then there's just a bunch of like different suits and things like that, acknowledgments and about the author and all that. But there's shuffling the deck. Let's see, what else does it say? Introducing the tarot. Regular tarot practice has many personal benefits, including increased self-awareness. Tarot gives you space to focus on yourself. Enhanced creativity. A tarot reading can offer a different perspective on a problem and innovated ways forward. Better honed intention and physical ability. Tarot helps you see probable future events and influences, a way to empower others to find their spiritual path. A note on the Ride White Tarot, which I have, and actually I believe that might be this book here, because I have a book, I have the tarot cards as well. That was actually one of the very first decks I ever received, and it was given to me as a gift, but then I gave it away because when I met my husband, he was really into the church, and they thought that a lot of this stuff was like demonic and satanic and all that shit, so I wasn't able to keep my decks, so I ended up throwing it away. But then I ended up buying another one deck because I love my tarot cards. And to me, they're not anything evil. They're just something fun for me to do. And like these, like this said, it's just like a self thing, you know. And it also helps me concentrate. And it also makes me feel like positive. There's like a lot of positivity in what I feel like. I don't feel that it's a negative thing, because if I did, I wouldn't be doing this or whatever. I wouldn't even be like reading on it or, you know, showing you guys my decks and things, my oracle cards. I just feel like it's not, you know. And the thing of it is I will touch, I'm gonna go a little bit off subject in a rant here. But in my own opinion, like in my own experience, sometimes I feel that people just don't know enough about something. So they're scared of the unknown. And so it just gets to the point where they start like not really, how do I want to say this? Because I'm trying to say that this is what I'm just going to come out and say it, because I'm not going to sugarcoat it for anyone, whatever. I feel like some of these churches are the most judgmental people I've ever met in my life. And they don't even know a person and they're like, oh, you know, okay, I'll tell you a story. And this really happened to me. This was my experience, okay? I'm outside, and we used to live in a trailer park before we moved into our house. And I was sitting there and just minding my own business. I was at my father-in-law's house with my husband. We were just sitting outside, And then there was another guy there, and he was working on the deck because that's what he was doing. He was working on the deck, and we were all just standing around talking, whatever. And so I'm just sitting there doing nothing. I'm not even saying much of anything. All of a sudden, the wife of the guy who's working on the deck comes down, and she starts asking me questions. Questions that shouldn't even been asked. Like, why do you wear black all the time? Are you serious? Are you serious? What difference does it make what color I wear all the time? What's it to you? Why do you want to know? And I feel like she was trying to get at, oh, are you worshiping Satan? Are you a Satanist? I have a bad feeling that that's what she was getting at. And I just said to her, I said, I like black. It's my favorite color. And I love black. It's true. It's my favorite color. And I love wearing black. Like, almost my whole entire wardrobe is black. And I feel like it's the most fun color to wear. And it's slimming on me. And I feel like it makes me feel comfortable. I don't like to be a big, bold fucking color. I don't like colors that much. I mean, yeah, I do like some color, but I don't want to, like, I used to wear a lot of color, don't get me wrong, but I just got so sick of wearing color. I'm just, like, not into that anymore. I mean, I'll wear bits and pieces of color, but most of my outfit's gonna be black. And so when she said that to me, I thought, what? I'm like, let's just cut to the chase, you know? I'm thinking in my mind, like, what do you want to really know about me? I mean, because I feel like she was spreading rumors about me, about how I wasn't religious or whatever. You know what? I grew up Lutheran, since you want to know. I grew up Lutheran. I was confirmed or whatever. But you know what? Like, just because I went to church and I did all this doesn't mean that that religion is better than any other religion out there. As I've gotten older, my horizons have been opened to new things. Like, I want to learn more about different religions because, you know what? All over the world, people practice different religions. We don't even know enough. And people are like, once you go to a church or whatever, you get closed-minded about it. And I'm sorry, I don't mean to judge anyone. If you're religious, that's great. That's just great. You do it on your own thing. But for me, I was feeling pressured into going to that church and doing this and that. They were doing a whole lot of things wrong. I mean, what church has security with loaded guns at a church? Come on. Do you really need a loaded gun with security at a church? Should you? I don't think so. So when I met my husband, he basically had this one track mind that everything was bad. Like AC/DC was bad. All the rock music I used to listen to was bad. Everything was bad. Everything was demonic. Oh, I had demons around me and stuff. And I don't know what in the world. Like, I just feel like that church just sits there and, like, brainwashes people. You know what I mean? Like, don't push people's religion onto you. Like, everybody's got their own beliefs, what they believe in and what they don't. Don't push it on everyone else. Everybody's different. Everybody has the right to believe in whatever they want to believe in. And for me, my mind is open. I don't feel like any religion is more better than the other. And I don't look down upon people who do different things in worshiping whatever they want to worship, as long as they're not going to sit here and try and go push it on me. Because if you start pushing your religion on me, it's not going to turn out well. I'm sorry to disappoint you, but I'm not going to sit there and just, like, bend to that religion and only that religion. I'm not going to always feel like, oh, everybody's religion's wrong but mine. Because I've seen those types of people. And it's like, they're judging people and they're putting people down just because they have different beliefs than their own. For me, I'm like keeping my mind open, like really open on it. And so I don't think that one religion's better than the other. And as long as nobody's hurting anybody, it's not my job to sit there and like throw religion onto people, you know? I will say this though. If you're going to judge a religion, make sure you know what you're talking about. Like, educate yourself in the religion that you're going to, you know, if you're going to talk about it with someone or whatever, or you're going to argue about it, make sure you educate yourself. Because you know what? A lot of these people are making these assumptions. They're not even educating themselves. And they're like, oh, witchcraft. Oh my God. It's satanic. You know, just like this too. You know, it's like, you know what? I'm keeping open on a lot of different things. I believe in a lot of different things. And I'm not even going to, I guess, you know, later on, maybe I'll do a video on it. But I believe in a lot of different things. I don't just believe in one thing. And I don't think everything, I don't put anyone else's religion down. If you want to believe in something, you believe in that. Who cares what anybody else says or thinks about it? And if you want to choose to wear black and be yourself, or wear color and be yourself, that's fine. But don't just sit there and throw people under the bus and make shit up, because that's exactly what happened to me. Stuff was being made up about me, because then once I met with one of the friends that they were hanging out with, and she asked me questions about my religion. And she was surprised that because I was brought up a different way than what I think she was told. Because the person didn't really know me at all, didn't really even get to know me, and didn't even say anything about it. You know what I mean? Like, she didn't ask me anything. She just asked me, oh, why do you wear black all the time? Really? I don't go up to you and ask you why you wear color all the time. So why do you care? I mean, the only thing I could think of is that she thought I was Satanist, like a Satanist worshiper or something like that, which I'm not. Yes, I'm into tarot cards. Yes, I'm into oracle cards. Yes, I'm into, like, I do a lot of different things, like paranormal stuff, and I like spooky and Halloween, and I do like a lot of different gothic stuff, but that doesn't mean that I'm a Satan worshiper. Witchcraft and witches are not, it's not what people think. People are mistaken about it. All I can say is to those people is do your research. Educate yourself before jumping off the deep end and saying, oh, it's satanic. You're going to hell. Whatever. Like, that's what I got to say to those people. Whatever. But anyways, I knew I was going to go on a tantrum. You were warned. Sorry about that. But we'll get back into learning more about the tarot stuff. So another thing that this book says in here is it's how to begin. Tarot cards, like people, draw in energy. It's important to not to let others touch your cards occasionally. They hold your energies and intentions and are personal to you. Here are ways to attune to your new deck. Cleanse the cards before a reading session and protect them when you are not using them. So here's some of the steps that you need to do too for a new deck. Attuning to a new deck. The process of connecting with your cards is called attuning. The more connected you feel to your cards, the more accurate, insightful, and inspiring your readings can be. Before you begin reading a new deck of tarot cards, attune to them for exactly 7 days by sleeping with your cards under your pillow. Look at the cards daily and touch them so your energy becomes imprinted upon them. Some readers attune to their cards through visualization. Try this. Hold your cards in your hand. Number two, close your eyes. Take a deep breath. Visualize light pouring down through the crown of your head, third eye chakra, throat and heart, then down your right arm, into your right hand, and into the cards. Imagine your cards filling with pure light. If you work with your spirit guides or angels, ask them to come close and to help you and protect you during the reading. Open your eyes when you are ready. And here's how to cleanse your deck. Cleansing your deck before a reading session. When you take out your cards, clear away any old energy as follows. Hold the cards in one hand and fan them out. Gently blow on the card edges. You can do this in one breath. Put the cards back in the knee pile, still holding them in one hand, and then knock firmly once on the top of the deck. It is ready to use. So there's other things that you can do, like too. I've heard something about salt and sage on the cards to cleanse them as well. For the new cards or whatever. And it's on, I think it might be in this book here. I think it might be in that book, but it's not in this one, which is, you know, everything is different. Everybody's got their own way of doing this. So just, you know that this is just one way of doing things. Everybody's got their own way of doing stuff, I think. So, I mean, you know, they've got a shuffling the deck and a fan method, cutting the deck, turning over the cards, using the card interpretations. What about reveals, getting intuitive, card layouts, past, present, and future. And then it's got, here's like what, kind of like what the other cards were like. I don't know why I'm squinting my eyes. I think I'm just getting a little tired here. The week ahead. So there's a spread on the week ahead. There's also the Celtic cross, which we kind of went over in the animal, spirit animal book. Well, tarot card book. Now this one doesn't have the honeybee spread or whatever, the lover's honeybee spread. So, but then the rest of the book just kind of tells about the card interpretations. So you've got all the cards here, and like this is just for instance, they have like a picture of the card and it tells more about the card. And I'm not going to go through this whole thing, but you guys get the gist of it. It's just, it shows the picture, tells what the card is and all that stuff, and the element and all that stuff that's attached to the card. But this is the book here if you wanted to get it. It was at Spencer's, but I'm sure you can look it up online because a lot of stuff is kind of like crossed, you know, over to different book places. Like maybe Barnes and Noble's might even have it. Excuse me, I'm going to have a little sip of my dew here. It's probably around midnight. I did take a nap, so if I look tired, well, I stayed up late last night. We got up early from watching movies because we stayed up really late. And then we woke up early this morning, and I've been up doing chores or whatever. And then I fell asleep about a little after 3:30, I think it was. And I slept until a little after 6. So, and then I got up tonight. So, and my chores just wear me out. I try not to let them wear me out, but they do. I'm always tending to the cats and all that good stuff and cleaning the house every day and all that. So, always got a lot going on here. Okay, so this book here is basically just on the tarot deck itself. And so I'm just going to, now this tarot deck was like my very first one not this book particularly, because I did have another book that went with the tarot cards, and I got it from my friend Jason. His sister was going to throw away her tarot cards and some, I think there was some horoscope stuff, and I believe I still have those books, but his sister was going to throw away some of the tarot stuff. And so he got it for me. Well, then I ended up having to throw it away because, well, you know why. Not a cool thing at all to have happen, because I loved that. And when it becomes, like, when it's given to you, I heard it's more of, you know, it's more of a connected thing, you know. So, you know. So, anyways. Now, I know I have that tarot deck that belongs with the book I just showed you, but we are going to get into, let's see, so I'm unorganized during this video, so I apologize for that. I have my tarot cards and my oracle cards all together now, because I took them out of the drawer, and now they're all over the place. So now I have oracle cards and tarot decks. But let's just go through them as I get them, because I don't want to just sit there and try to organize them. But here is the Halloween Oracle deck. And I got this online. I believe this was through Amazon. And I just love this deck. I really haven't done a whole lot with this deck, but I want to. And the oracle cards you can read every day. So there's an orange lining inside, which is cool. And then you've got the book, and the book matches the cover. So it's really neat. I really like this deck a lot. I think it's really neat. And you've got a book. So it comes with the book, guys. And then it comes with the cards, which are right here inside the little thing. And let's see what this book has to offer, because we haven't really talked a whole lot about oracle stuff, but let's see what it says. It says, this deck is dedicated to all of those who still love to play on All Hallows Eve. May the jack-o'-lanterns burn brightly for you. Oh, how cute. Now, this one says, trick or treat, truth or dare, a little about the scariest night of the year. So it does tell a little bit about trick or treating. It's got a cute picture inside the book, which is kind of cool. Which, you know what, I may bring. I want to do a video. This reminds me. I want to do a video on, like, some of the facts and history of Halloween, because I love Halloween so much. And I've wanted to do it for so long, and I haven't done it. So I think this year, since I'm pressing on getting a lot of my videos done, I am going to try my hardest, guys, to get a video for you guys. I'm going to try to do the research and see if I can't get, like, you know, a video set aside, even if it's just, like, talking about Halloween and talking about all the facts. Or, you know, saying all about what Halloween is and then what it means to me or something. I'm going to do a video. So be on the lookout for that video too. And it's got how to use the deck. It says here, since the art of divination is such a common one in the night, allow me to recommend a few ways to use this deck. The single card definition below is perfect for when you need a quick answer to a question or a little guidance for your day. The Halloween 3-card draw and the jack-o'-lantern divination below are two recommended spreads for more complex division. They will provide a more in-depth and comprehensive view of your situation. So there's a single card one, and there's a Halloween 3-card draw. There's a jack-o'-lantern one, which I'm going to show you guys. So this one kind of reminds me a little bit of, like, the past present and whatever, but this is what it says. It says there's a three-fold cycle. Birth, death, and rebirth is a very important when connecting with Halloween. We honor this through this spread, also as Halloween is most tied to the moon, and that the night symbolically, you might like to try consulting this spread at moonrise or midnight. So this is kind of cool. The heart of the issue or question would be the number one card. The challenge is number two, and the solution. So this is like the three thing of the cards. I think that is super, super cool. And then they've got the jack-o'-lantern one. And this one is highly protective and eliminating spread. You will pull six cards. They look like the eyes, nose, and teeth of a scary jack-o'-lantern. Oh, that's so cute. I never really thought about it like that before. And the number one card is the heart of the issue or question. Number two is the hidden issue. The number three is the major obstacle. Number four is the main fear. Card number five is the solution. Number six, what will happen if you engage in the solution? So here's a picture of, look at, it is like a little jack-o'-lantern's face. That is super cool. I really want to try this. Now, this deck, I really haven't used much yet, but I really want to use it. Dedicating your cards. It says for that, people like to do that to clean theirs. If you get outdoors, this can be by the sea, upon the earth, or up in the sky. Otherwise, choose a place you like within your home to perform the. You will need bay leaves, sage, frankincense for burning, salt, purified sea salt, and a silver candle. Burn some bay leaves, sage, or frankincense, or all three. Allow them to burn and smoke frequently. Throw some salt upon the pack. Say, I cleanse, I renew, I protect. Then light a silver candle and say, I ask that the power of the elements and the seasons bless me and these cards. I ask for guidance and truth, awakening and clarity, and strength and courage to make changes should I need to. And here is a picture, and it says the cards, and it's got a black kitty, which is cute. And if you look, there's like two little eyes there. It's kind of neat. And it says the cards. So it's got all these cards and what their explanations are. So it's kind of like the tarot books, but these are different. And I mean, you can do these every day to predict like the day that you're going to have and stuff like that. So this is a really good one, and I really like this because, like I said, this is like my favorite holiday, and this isn't really just a holiday for me per se. This is like a lifestyle, so this is definitely something that I am like, because I love animals, and I also love Halloween, so this is my deck for sure. There's no ifs, ands, buts about it. I was drawn to that deck. And I actually had it on my watch list. I think it was from eBay. It could have been eBay or Amazon, but I really think it was eBay. Some of these cards, and of course it was new. It was in the plastic still. So, I'm sorry. Tonight, my voice is cracking and everything, because I just really am not, my throat is, well, not my throat, but it's like, I don't know. There's something going on with my throat. Oh. Sorry, I had to take another drink. Okay, so this one is probably the one deck that I just recently got. But it's, I think it was like last fall I got this deck. We went to a shop in Mason City. and they sell like comic book shop type of thing. And they had a whole bunch of this show stuff, and I ended up buying a few posters. I ended up buying some little, you know, like the little pins. I ended up buying a car, a little car, model car of theirs. And what else did I get? Some patches, because I was going to put it on a purse or something and make a purse. A supernatural purse. Well, anyways, here is the deck. This is one of my newest ones that I bought, like, today. You know what I mean? To date. I think it was last summer when I did this, or last fall when I got this. Or maybe it could have been winter. I just don't remember. I don't remember, but I know that it was last fall, I think it was. So here's a picture of it. Supernatural, guys. My favorite TV show. There's Dean and Sam, and there's Baby the car. And then this one is a tarot deck, of course. And here's the inside of it. It's kind of cool. And then here's the guide. So we will take out the guide and we will see what that's all about. And here's the top of the cards and what those look like. It's pretty neat. And here is the book part. And then there's on the back, the spine, Supernatural. And so, and this book hasn't really been bent in yet. So it has introduction. And it has like a bunch of the understanding of the deck. So it does tell you stuff. It shows some pictures of the deck. And of course they have Dean and Sam are the Fool cards. Now that is funny. What? The Fools? They're not fools. Here's the Magician. This is kind of fun to look through. Oh, the High Priestess. I agree with this card because I love her. She's my favorite witch ever. Well, maybe she's tied with like Sandra Bullock and Practical Magic and Elvira. And well, I think Morticia Adams was a witch too. So maybe, you know, they're all... Oh my goodness. This lady, if you don't know, she plays one of the Reaper guys. The Lovers. The Chariot. I agree with that card. It's Baby. Oh, Strength. He was a good guy. Whoops, spoiler alert. Sorry, guys. The Hermit. And guess who the Hermit is? Bobby. The Wheel of Fortune. I don't know that one. It's just like a little thing right there. Oh, yeah, that was the rabbit foot. I remember that. EX. The Hanged Man. I don't know if I agree with that one, but... Cassio. Oh, here's the Death card. I totally agree with that. Because that is Death himself. Which I loved how they introduced him in the series. If you've ever watched Supernatural, you know what I'm talking about. It is freaking amazing. Oh, here's the Devil, Lucifer himself. Which, that is the guy who plays Lucifer on the show. The Tower. Oh, yeah. the star, which is Jack. The moon. The sun. I can see that about her. The judgment. The world. This is kind of fun to look through this with you guys because, yeah. Then they've got all these bone cards too. They've got lots of different, and then the pentagrams. And by the way, guys, speaking of pentagrams, they weren't a bad situation. If you know what I'm saying, they weren't a bad one. We'll get more into that later because I have more to dig up on that subject. But they weren't a bad one at all. Just so you know. Then it goes through the all of the different methods and caring for the deck. And it says like some different card options to do for tarot spreads. There's a five card option. And let's see. Well, of course, there's the three card option because it's always going to be. And here's the non-possession thing. I would love to get a tattoo of that. There's so many people that have a tattoo of that, though. And that's not a bad thing. I just really want my tattoos to tell a story and whatnot. Weather Channel's giving me a notification on my phone. Oh, and here's the three cards, of course. We've got the three card spread. I think that one's like a popular one to do. Because it's like past, present, future. And here's an apple pie. An apple pie spread. Good old Dean and his pies. He loves pies. If you haven't seen Supernatural, you need to check it out. Because it is like really a good show. I love it so much. But here's the Supernatural deck. It's just like, you know, it's cool. I'm glad I bought it. I have not played that yet though. So I have not used these cards at all. Probably a lot of these decks I haven't even used. Because number one, I just don't have the time to do it. And number one, that's my number one reason why. But then also, I don't have the energy to do it sometimes because I'm so tired on so many different levels. Okay, guys, I believe these came out like last year too, and I think I got these at Mall of America the same time I got my backpack. My backpack is basically the same color, so it doesn't have this on it though, but it is a Jack Skellington backpack. I think you've seen these in a video on my Mall of America video. I think it was one of those. And here's the inside of the box. And here's this. So this is the Tim Burton's, Disney's The Tim Burton's Nightmare Before Christmas tarot deck and guidebook. So it does come with a guidebook. I believe that they all have their own guidebooks. So it'll tell, each guidebook will tell you how to care for your deck. And it will have like introduction to show you how to use your deck. And these are some pretty, I would love, like, doesn't this look like a little wallpaper? I would love some wallpaper like that. It would be cute. I put it in my downstairs bathroom. Because it's like, that would be perfect in there. For some reason, I just feel like it would. This is like spooky inside, which is kind of cool, you know, the inside of this. Of course, it tells the introduction, which shows like, you know, what's going, you know, about your deck. Understanding your tarot deck. I've got that in each and every book. And then there's a couple pages of that. And then it says, Then it goes right into which ones, which cards are what. And this has color illustrations on the cards and things. So it's pretty cool and it's self-explanatory. And I'm sure they've got, yes, on the in the back of the book, there is different types of card drawings you can do, card layouts, the spreads, they call them, which I don't know why I couldn't think of the word, maybe just because I'm tired or whatever, but here's a 3 spread, which is, like I said, the most popular spread, I think, that people do. I really do like the lover, the honeybees lovers spread or whatever it's called. There's another 3 one in this one. I've never seen that before. Meant to be spread. And I'm surprised they don't have the Celtic one in here. But I'm sure you could do like some of the other spreads with this deck still, because it's basically, you know, they're themed. You know, they're themed decks. I love Jack Skellington, so of course I got this deck. And I haven't used this one either yet. So, like I said, I haven't had a whole lot of time to actually, you know, sit down and do these decks. But I kind of want to. I kind of want to do the Oracle ones a lot. I just think it would be fun. So maybe one night I'll get myself ready and I'll do some Oracle card readings or something. Here's another one. This is Moonology and this is Oracle cards deck, and it's a 44 card deck and guidebook, it says. And by the way, the last one was a tarot deck from and I don't think I've got prices on any of these, so I'm sorry. I didn't go over prices, but I don't remember the prices of all this stuff. And I believe I got this at a witchy store because I saw it and I was drawn to it. I love the moon, so it could have been from maybe Earthbound or something. Let the moon be your guide. I love the moon, so I love the phases of the moon. I love crescent moons. I love the full moon. I love all of the moon phases because the moon is beautiful and the stars and everything. I just love it. Oh, cute. A new start is coming. I am definitely going to play with this one, I think. Well, not play with it, but you know what I mean. I'm going to do this one, I think. And so it tells a little bit about it in this book here. It's a guidebook. So it's got a lot of different things in this one. An introduction, of course, like it normally does. What these cards are for. So basically what it says is what the cards are for is creating your life. Number 2, planning your life. And 3, predicting your life. And it also tells you how to bless the cards. The wisdom of the moon. It gets into that. The phases of the moon. So it goes into the phases of the moon. And it's got a little phase chart and what it means and things like that, which is kind of cool. So it's got a lot of knowledge on stuff like that. The moon cards, the full moon cards, the special moon cards. Interpreting the cards, overall interpretations, additional meanings, attuned to the moon, the teaching, the elements, which is fire, earth, air, and water. And it tells you the signs. So you got your horoscope signs with whatever. I believe I'm earth because I'm earthy sign. Yep, Capricorn's an earth sign. And then it also shows you some spreads, working with cards and spreads. You've got a 6 spread. Well, no, this one's a 10 spread. The Celtic cross spread. A 3 card spread. And there's a 4-card spread. Moon phase cards. So then it starts getting into your cards, and it's just got like a whole bunch of different cards that, and it tells what they are, and I'm sure it tells the elements and all that good stuff. And then I think in the back, it tells about the artist of the deck, and it tells you how to attune to the moon. So, there you go, guys. So, this is a good deck. I really like this deck. And I want to play with it so much. Well, why do I say play with it? I don't know. I just want to, like, do it. It's got a little thing on the back, too, before I forget. But each deck has came with its own booklets to tell you about the deck and how to take care of it and what spreads you can use and things like that. And I'm sure, like I said, the spreads probably can be used all like each other. Now, this deck I was drawn to, and I believe I got this from a witchy store, it's called the Cat Tarot, which everybody knows me, knows that I love cats. So, and here's like a little preview of the case. It's upside down for some reason. And I'm sure and so this one here also has a little booklet, and here's the cards on the top, which are cute, and it's got the little card booklet inside. Now I'm sure this also has, and I'm sure it has the, this is a tarot book, or a tarot card deck, guys, if you're wondering, which I forgot. Okay. So, it does the Celtic Cross one for the spreads in here. Let's see what other spreads it's got. It's got the 5-card spread, the paw, they're calling it, the single card, the 3-card spread, the deck, preparing for the reading. So, I mean, they have everything that you need to know is in these little books. The Celtic Cross, which they're calling the Wolf. Horseshoe, the Cat Stretch. And that's a 7-card. Ooh, this one's got quite a few in here. The Belly Rub, the Mandela, they're calling it. And it's shaped like this. That's kind of cool, right? I've never seen that one before. Then they've got the Tree of Life, and it kind of looks like a tree from afar. It's kind of cool. The Reading. Then it's got all of your cards and what they look like, and it tells what each cat card is. Ooh, that one's kind of a pretty card. And so there's many, many different cats in here. I want to get a white one because, well, of course it goes white. My kitty, I loved her so much. I still love her, but I miss her so much. She passed away when she was 7, I think it was 16 or 17. She got really sick from the water that where we used to live. And she got really sick from the water, and she had a urinary tract infection. I thought she was getting out of it. And then it just got worse, and then she didn't get any better, and she passed away. So, but we had to put her to sleep because she wasn't passing away on her own. But she was bad. I mean, she couldn't even shut her eyes. She was really, really bad, guys. I wish that never happened because I just love her so much. Look at this cute little kitty. Not to change the subject, but look at the little kitties hanging out. That's so cute. This deck is really, really me, too. I have so many decks that are me, which I love. But I haven't hardly done anything with the decks. Here is a Gothic tarot one from Anne Stokes. And she does a lot of, like, I love her artwork and stuff like that. So when I saw this deck, I automatically just ordered it. And I believe I ordered it from eBay. And of course, this has a small booklet inside of it too. But we're, you know, you're supposed to like put your things in a box or like have little bags. I got these velvet bags online, but I ran out of the bags, so I don't have a whole lot. So I only put some of them in the bags that can fit. Otherwise, I don't have enough bags to put on my cards, which I should buy more, which I keep forgetting to do. Because these are in a drawer and I don't really think about them that often. So this is something that I got at a witchy shop. It's a gypsy witch fortune-telling playing cards with instructions. And I just thought this was so cool, so I had to get it. And it's just a small box of cards, but I think it would be... This is something that I really want to do some cute things with, but it's cute, right? Hi, are you trying to play with the bag? Miss Charm, you're a wild animal. Oh, she's going to move the tripod. She's coming through. Here is another one. And I bought these from Spirit Halloween a couple years ago. And they're these tarot cards as well. And I believe this comes with the book too. This has got... standard 78 card deck. So, and here's the back of it or whatever. I haven't played this very much, I don't think. Why am I saying played? I don't get it. Like, I haven't used them. That's what I need to say. Not played with. Because these are not something to play with. My tiredness tonight, man. I'm serious. Seriously, freaking just... I feel warm and stuff, too, because I don't know. I'm always feeling so warm in this room when I do videos and stuff. And the only thing is, I only have one light on and then the light's in back of me, so I don't get why it gets so warm. And see, these are brand new deck, and that goes with that book that I was showing you guys. But this probably has a mini book inside, too. This is the original and only authorized edition of the famous 78 card deck, tarot card deck. And it shows by the person, so. I don't know. This one here is a good deck. It's, you know, one of those solid ones, so. Eventually, I will figure that out, too. I wonder if it's, like... stopped raining and stuff because I don't hear it anymore, so it's kind of odd and weird because I thought it was supposed to rain longer than what it did, but maybe it's past 1 o'clock in the morning now. I just don't know what time it is because I'm using my phone to record this, so I have no idea what time it is. Just know that after this I'm going to bed. This is my third video tonight that I filmed, and I'm just getting really kind of tired, you know. Here's another Oracle card deck. Unicorns, of course, because, well, I love unicorns. If anybody doesn't know, I love unicorns. Let's give this deck a little try here. Well, the book, anyway. I want to see what the book looks like. The cards are really beautiful. This particular card right here on the top, and there's a glare on the card, I see it. But this particular one here is by Sue Dow, the drawings or whatever, I think. I love her artwork. She's one of my favorites. When I was younger, they used to have folders and stuff of her artwork on them when I was going back to school and stuff. Oh my god, I loved all of her artwork so much. I started collecting it, and then when I moved here, I had to throw stuff away, because when I moved, I couldn't take everything with me, so I had to throw a lot of it away. And some of those sadly ended up in the garbage, which sucks. But I do have a lot of the artwork saved, so I could print it out. And I know it's not the same, but I can still print it out if I wanted to and, like, put it in a folder or something. And Miss Charmy's, like, looking at me like, come on, everybody's sleeping and everywhere and there's nowhere for me to sleep. Well, she's got a cat tree, but she doesn't really want to sleep in the cat tree, I don't think. And Mooney's over here sleeping on this side of the couch. And we've got Punky in a little laundry basket. I've got a pillow with some blankets on it and stuff like that. Hey, Charmy. Charmy. She's trying to get into something. Charmy, come here. Charmy, come here. What are you doing? Huh? What are you doing? Mama's almost ready for the done with the video, and then we can have some time. Do you want to spend time with Mama? Okay, you can spend time with me. I love you. You're purring now. Well, you can lay down up there. Lay down up there. You don't want to lay it down up there, honey? Oh, you're moving the tripod. She's moving, you guys. Okay. All right, let me finish this video and then I'll be with you in a minute. But I think this is like a gorgeous little tarot deck. Hey, she's trying to get into something else. Hey, no, no, come here. You can't do that. You're going to get into too much stuff. Come on. I think she's doing it because I'm giving her attention now and she wants attention from me. Anyways, guys, here's the Oracle card deck of the unicorns. I think this would be a good tarot deck. If you like unicorns and stuff, it's a really good thing. And, of course, it's got, like, the same things as the other ones, like prepare your deck, you know, left-handed, right-handed. That's something that was different. How to work with the magical unicorn Oracle cards. Prepare your card deck. Hey, Charmy, no, no. No wires. She's trying to play with my extension cords and my other stuff. No, that's not going to fly. Uh-uh. Come here. Hey, no, no. Now she's trying to play with my feathers on my dream catcher. Hey, no. Charm. No, no. I know you're trying to get my attention. If you just give me a couple minutes, I'll be done with this video, honey. Just give me a couple more minutes, okay? Give me 15 more minutes. Or maybe 10 minutes. I think she's going to go out into the hallway or something. Or play with something else. But anyways, guys, this is the meanings of magical unicorn oracle cards. Then there's, like, believe in yourself. There's, like, positive messages on these cards. Creative. And this is like something that I think I would do daily readings with. And they have about the author, and there's like a bunch of different artwork and stuff like that on this. And I'm trying to find if they've got any spreads in this one, because I don't know. And a lot of this stuff is like pseudo. And there's basically, if you want to order artwork, you can. There's like a whole bunch of different, they're giving. I think a lot of these are not from, like, some of them are pseudo. And there's some that are like other artwork. And they basically have like the artwork and the name of the artist on in this book in the back. So it's pretty cool. Like, they must have a bunch of artists working together, because I know this one for a fact is pseudo, because I used to have a notebook like that when I was in high school, or maybe I was fourth grade or something. But I remember my parents got me some cool stuff for my notebooks and my folders And they had some Sue Dowell drawings on them, which I loved her. All the unicorn ones, like, she did a lot of cool unicorn ones. She also did, like, fairies and mermaids and dragons and wizards. She did so many cool things. Let me see here. Since, let's just, I'm not seeing any spreads. So, you know, just kind of go with the flow with that one. But let's check this out. Let's check out these unicorn cards. Here's a unicorn on the back side of the cards. This is what it looks like. I think that's pretty cool. And then there's gold. I'm not really a gold fan, guys. I'm more attracted to silver. So, but this particular drawing was by Sue Dowell. And that's the type of thing she would draw. And I'm not, I don't think this one was by her at all. There's like a glare sometimes on that. And here's another one. But that one's not by her either. And neither is this one. Now, I kind of want to say this one might be by her. But I'm not 100% sure. This one is definitely not by her. But it's cute and I like it. This one is by her for sure. Because I used to have a folder like that. God, I love her unicorns. She draws such awesome unicorns. This one's not by her though. There's other artists in this deck. This one is by her. You can tell her style. After a while, you'll be able to tell her style when you're looking at it. This one's by her as well. This one, I don't think is by her, but it might. It might be by her, but I don't. It's definitely. This one, I used to have a big framed art piece of this one. I loved it so much. A baby and a mom unicorn. That's so cute. That was by her. This one, I don't think is by her. But I could be wrong. This one's not by her. And this one is probably by whoever created the back of the cards. Because it looks, the artwork looks a little bit similar. This one is by Sue Dowell. This one is by the same creator that created this. There's similarities of that, for sure. This one, not real sure. But it's cute. This one, I believe this one was by Sue Dowell. She's a talented artist. I really like her. Here's another one by Sue Dowell. And of course, Charms playing this stuff again. This one is cute. This one's kind of cute. This one's kind of cute. This one kind of reminds me of a Flutter Pony. And it's just because one of the legs looks longer than the other if you look at it. So that's kind of like a weird shape one. But it reminds me of a Flutter Pony from My Little Ponies. I'm a huge fan of My Little Ponies. I love My Little Ponies. Even to this day, I like collecting all of, like, those types of old school toys. I love them. They're so cute. Here's a Pegasus unicorn. And why do I feel, oh yeah, I do have two cards. I was like, why do I feel like I have two cards? Because I do. This one might be by Sue Dow, but I'm not 100% sure. And there's a dog barking, and it's like really early in the morning. Somebody let the dog inside. Hopefully they do. It's weird because tonight I keep hearing like a beeping noise and I don't know what it is. It's like, what the heck is that? It's weird. And I've heard it all night. And I know I'm hearing bats outside too. It was funny because it was like around midnight and it was last weekend. I think it was last Sunday night. And people were screaming outside and I was like, what the hell? Because I could hear screaming, but I didn't know why. I opened up our window in the hallway to check and see what was actually going on. And the girl or whatever, she was sitting down there with her mom. And I think the one of their kids was outside with them too, like the little boy. And then there was the sister, which was older. And she's like, oh, look, there's a bird. And they're like, oh, that's not a bird, that's a bat. And they started screaming Bloody Mary or murder and stuff. I'm like, it is only a bat. Like, come on. If you don't want it by you, don't be outside. Go inside the house. Don't just sit there and scream. Like, they were screaming loud. And I'm surprised that the neighbors didn't say anything. And I wasn't going to say anything either, but I was like, why are you screaming over a bat? It's outside, it's in its normal environment, and you're going to, I don't get it. But this one's by Sue Dow too, this Pegasus. Some more unicorns. Some more unicorns. Some more unicorns. Now, I like the way that what these cards have to say. They're very positive. So, these are an awesome deck to have. I just love unicorns. So, they're awesome. And here's another Sue Dow unicorn. She has so many different pictures and stuff. I should check to see if she's got an oracle card just for her stuff. She's got like a lot of different types of drawings and works that she's done over the years. She's got more than enough to do 78 even. She's got like tons and tons of artwork. So, and now we're back to the very front card again. So, this was the unicorn deck, oracle deck. But yeah, I think that would be so cool to have one by just her. That'd be awesome, because I love her. Ooh, this box is sticking. Gotta put down my cards. The box is sticking. Arr. Here's the back of the box. Now let's put this stuff in here. This one I want to try using some of these. Now this one didn't come with a... Oh yeah, it did come with a book. I was like, what? Because I remember showing you guys the book. A little tired tonight. Anyways, guys, there was my tarot cards. I thought I had more oracle cards than what I do, but I only think I only have, let's see, one, two, I think I only have three decks of oracle cards and the rest are all tarot decks. But anyways, guys, thank you guys so much for watching if you've lasted this long. I know the video went on for a lot longer than what I was thinking it was going to go for. So I hope you guys enjoy these videos. If you guys want to join the spooky family, we would love to have you. So please subscribe if you haven't already. Please don't forget to check that bell so that you can get the notifications as soon as I upload some more new videos, which is coming soon. Also, speaking of coming soon, I will have a movie suggestion list for Halloween out 2022, because well, for 2022, I do one every year, so I'm going to be doing like a movie suggestion list for Halloween, and I try to keep it family friendly, but then you know, you can't always, because, you know, so it probably won't be family friendly. It'll probably just, I kind of just go through the list and say, well, this is what my opinion is, you know, is it's for kids, for family, for non-kids. That's kind of what I do with the list. So that'll be coming up shortly here. I want to do that, I think, for October. I want to have that video for you guys by October, so you guys can get a movie list together. Also, maybe recommend some shows that I watch, things like that to add to the movie list, or maybe do one separate, maybe do two videos of like that kind of thing. I'm going to be doing some more hauls. I know I got more hauls lined up on the channel for spooky and Halloween hauls, and I do have some, I kind of want to do a couple more ghost stories, which they will also be lined up. You may have seen them already, but one of them I know is out already, but the other two are scheduled. I've been doing two videos a week, or trying to. Last week I accidentally slipped because I thought that I had a video that I already did, but there was no other video. So I only did a haul video, but I'm trying to do one haul video and then one video like these for each week. So you'll get one haul video and one other video. But when October is finished, I don't know how far in October I'm going to be doing hauls, because at some point in time I got to stop. I mean, it is what it is. But I do want to do maybe a couple more hauls. I've got three scheduled. It probably will be in the middle of September, I think, is my last haul that I've got scheduled so far. I'm not saying that it's going to be done, but I think that's what I have so far as of, what is today, the 25th, 26th of August, 27th, wait, today's the 28th maybe, I don't know, I think it's August 28th right now. I could be wrong. I think it is. Let's go with that. So as of the 28th, I've got one for this coming up week, which will be scheduled, I think, on Friday. And then, well, that would be September 2nd, I think. I believe so. So September 2nd, you will see a video. It might be a haul. I think it is one. But if not, it's more of like a, you know, fun thing. Then you'll also see another video, I believe. And I think it's a ghost story one, if I remember correctly. Because I just put those out tonight. I just recorded those tonight. And they're going to get to you guys in September. So I'm going to try to keep this going. I want to do two videos a week. I don't know when, like during the off season, I probably won't be doing hauls every week. I probably won't be doing as many videos, but I'm going to try to do something, you know, here and there. So I'm also needing to do my room tour, which I know I keep saying, and this is like a broken record, but it will be coming eventually. I'm not going to put a date or a time on it, because it just doesn't work out for me. And then I get you guys all excited and then it just doesn't happen. So the room tour will eventually happen. It's just, I've got a couple more things that I got to do in here first. And it may be after Halloween. So, stay tuned for that. That'll keep you guys stay tuning for that. I'm also thinking about doing some crafting, and showing you guys maybe some Christmas ornaments that you can make for spooky trees. For if you want to do like a spooky Christmas tree for Christmas, or what I like to call Gothmas. So I might be doing some of that. I'll show you some of the ornaments that I've already made and tell you how I made them. I made them years ago, but I have them on my trees right now. And also, I have to fix one of our trees because we actually have two of them up. I have a white one and a black one. And so I kind of have to fix that, fix the trees before I show you, because one of them looks awful right now. I have to fluff it out more and stuff like that because it fell over. The cats knocked it over and then the ornaments went all over the place on it. So I got to fix that. There's going to be other videos coming up like those types of things. I kind of want to do some crafty things as well. We'll see how far I get. I don't want to go too far ahead because what if I don't get them done? Because sometimes I don't. I just don't get them done as much as I want to. So we'll see how far we get. And I just wanted to kind of give you a list and say that I'm not going to disappear right now because there's so many good videos that I want to do. And I'm doing a really good job on trying to keep track of doing videos. Like, I've wanted to do this video for, like, the longest time. So, but you know, another thing is I could do is also, if you guys really was interested in seeing this, I may do some, like, spreads of cards just so you guys can see. And then maybe possibly doing some, like, getting my cards ready or cleansing my cards. If you guys wanted to see that, just let me know, like, write in the comments below if you want to see that, or I'll just do a video anyways. It just doesn't matter, because then that way it's like, you know, maybe a follow-up video with this one, maybe, possibly. It might be something, if you guys are interested in that, I could do one. If not, well, you know, there's going to be other content coming. So there's going to be hauls and things like that. And I kind of want to do some Halloween crafting. And I was going to show you guys how to prepare some food and stuff like that, but I'm not having a Halloween party this year, unfortunately. The last couple I've had, see, I put in all my time and effort, money into these Halloween parties. And I have done a lot of different snacks, from just, you know, cutting out the little things with cheese, with cutters, like cookie cutters, the ones that stamp that you can get at Michael's that are kind of small. I will cut my cheese into slices and then I just do that. I've done lots of different desserts and things like that. When I'm hosting a Halloween party, I go all out. But then sometimes, you know, people just back out last minute. And that's not okay with me. A lot of times it's just, it's hard because I go and I get all the food. I got the playlist list going. I've got the gift bags because, yes, I give out gift bags. We have prizes that we do with games and things. You can win a gift bag by playing or by getting here at a certain time and staying here a certain time. There's all kinds of games like that, or find the glittered pumpkin, which I hide, and then whoever gives me the glittered pumpkin, they get a gift bag. So not everybody wins, but, and I go out and I try to get all the stuff ready for the gift bags, because I gotta find all this stuff and then make sure it's a cute gift bag. And then I do a lot of other things for the Halloween parties. I decorate inside, outside. I do all of the, you know, cleaning and cooking. Oh, you get to see a little bit of Mooney. She just stood up and turned around. How cute. She looks kind of cranky right now. Probably because it's so late and I'm talking to you guys. But yeah, there's like a whole bunch of things that I do to prepare for the parties and stuff. But this year, I've decided to just chill out and relax for a while because it's just getting to be too much for me. Plus, another thing is, I'm just getting sick of the leftover food because people will say they're coming. I go out and I'll buy all this food, and then guess what? It doesn't get eaten. It gets wasted. My husband gets pissed off, and he just doesn't want to deal with, like, you know, and I just get sick of hearing the excuses that people throw at me. It's like, I pour my heart out, I put all my effort into it, and then this person just doesn't even, like, she'll call me last minute and just cancel and say, oh, I'm out. Like, what was that? I buy enough food for everyone. So, you know, I end up having tons and tons of leftover food, and it's not just her. There's other people that do that stuff. But she does it every year. So it's to be expected, for real. Just got old quick, and I'm not going to run after everybody, and I don't really care. Like, it is what it is, and you know what? I'm actually spending more energy and time into enjoying my season this year, so I get to enjoy more of my season, and it's less money for me to have to fork out for food and groceries and things like that for everyone. So it's actually, like, less stressful because I don't have to cook, I don't have to clean, I don't have to, you know, do all the stuff, the gift bags and all that. I do have a playlist that I use every year, but I always add more and more to it. I think the playlist is around 25 to 30 hours of music. So we would never get like, you know, use all the music. But you know what? When we are cooking and cleaning and things like that, it's nice to have that playlist because it's, like, on a lot. And then not even, that's not even counting decorating. Every year I have a different theme, like color theme and scheme. And, like, you know, the characters of that. So there's a lot that goes into planning a Halloween party. And I don't take it lightly. Because it's basically, for me, it's not a time of the year. It's more of a lifestyle for me. It's not just a holiday. It's a lifestyle. So I take things, like, very seriously. And then I want to just have fun. Well, by the time the party comes, I put so much effort into it. Like, I give all my energy towards it. By the time the night of the party is, I'm not gonna lie, I'm freaking exhausted. And I can't give enough energy to lift everybody up and, like, you know, put that energy into my party and stuff. So it gets a little bit too much sometimes, you know? So that's kind of, like, where I'm at with the Halloween party thing. I'm not going to have one this year, which will probably be best. That way I can concentrate on just enjoying the season, whatever. I'm not inviting the person that keeps canceling. If I had one, I'm not going to invite them back because I don't want the excuses. I'm sick of it. I'm over it. It's so, like, it's just not cool. Like, you just don't do that. I poured my heart out because I was getting a little depressed and I needed this person. Like, I just was asking one day and one night from them. And they couldn't even give me that. They're like, oh yeah, if I get off work. Well, they got off work. They sure as hell didn't come here. They called me up that day and told me about it. They told me that they weren't coming, and they told me the reason why, and I'm just, like, really, like, it was just so heartbreaking and stupid and everything. It's like, whatever. I'm just completely done with that, because I mean, if you accept things, you're teaching people how to treat you, and that's never a good thing. To, like, keep accepting people's excuses over and over and over again. And it's always something every freaking year. And I'm just tired. I'm done. Like, I don't want to deal with it. Like, this is why I say people earn this shit. You know what I mean? Like, you earn it. If I'm, like, cutting you off and telling you I'm not gonna, like, you know, I don't want you to come to my parties and you're not really invited here and you're not welcome here, whatever, then it's like, I'm done with you. Like, I'm done. I'm not going to sit there and chase after people. That's something I'm not going to do. Not going to chase after people. I'm not going to listen to their damn excuses anymore. You're either going to be here or you're not. And I always tell people a year in advance so they have more than enough time to plan. You have more than enough time to plan stuff. And if you can't make it because something better comes along, that's part of your problem. Like, you don't use me as an afterthought. You just don't do it. Like, be respectful. I would never do that to them. So why they have to do that to me, I don't get it. Because I poured my heart out. I put in a lot of effort and stuff and time into that. And it's like, I'm done. I'm washing my hands of it. Positive energy only. And I'm letting more other people have a chance to. It's actually given me a lot of. I felt good about it when I let that go, because that was last year. I let it go. I haven't talked to them much. I don't really care to talk to them, but whatever, it is what it is. But like, I'm just so at peace with myself now. And I'm also in a different place in my life where it's like, I really don't care. Like, you do whatever you're going to do, and I'll do whatever I'm going to do. And that's it. Like, you don't need to come here. I'm not going to beg and plead for you to come here. I'm not chasing after you. I'm not going to believe your 50,000 excuses. I'm not going to sit there and be second best or an afterthought just because something better comes up and you choose to do that instead of come and hang out with me. You could have came out here earlier and hung out with me for the day or helped me with stuff. It would have been nice. Instead, they planned something else with somebody else and ended up having to do something with them. And it's like, COVID was still a thing. And so I don't understand the reasons for it. And they could have had other people do whatever they're going to do. So it is what it is. All I know right now is I'm happy with what's going on in my life. I've opened up to new people. So it actually makes me feel more energy, peace, at peace with everything. I feel better about the situations at hand. I'm just feeling a lot better. So I don't really need to be chasing people because I understand my worth. And if they don't understand it, that's their problem. Like, I'm not going to go running after anyone. I'm not going to believe any thousands and thousands of excuses because every time they got one, and I'm done. So with that being said, guys, just don't let anyone do that to you, because don't believe all their excuses. Don't do that. Because you're actually teaching them how to treat you. And if they think that they can get away with it over and over and over because you forgive them and you keep doing this over and over, they're going to just think that they can get away with it all the time. And that's no way to even treat someone. As an afterthought, and you're gonna call like that day during the party, I'm getting ready, and you're gonna call that day and tell me or text me that? Like, what? It was just stupid. The whole thing was dumb. But the thing of it is just release those people. Those people, just release them. Let them just go do their own thing. Let them just be. Let them just go. Because you don't need it. You don't need to be an afterthought. You should not be anyone's afterthought. You should be everyone's first choice. And if you can't be anyone's first, if you can't be their first choice, guess what? Bye. See you later. Like, I don't need you. That's what you need to tell them. Because you deserve better than that. Everybody deserves better than that. No one needs to be deserved or treated like they're a second choice or an afterthought. Remember that. If they don't want to hang out with you first and foremost, then they don't deserve you at all. if they want to hand you a million excuses of why they can't be there, and you've asked them one day out of the year, one day out of the year, that's the thing, and you gave them a year to plan, and they still have excuses. See where we're going with this? Like, that's not a good look. It's not. I deserve better. You guys deserve better out there. If somebody's treating you like an afterthought, move on. Forget them. They don't deserve you. You're giving them way too many chances. I should have gave up that a long time ago. When my husband told me to. Because I was giving this person way too many chances. And she didn't deserve any of them. So don't sit there and like give them like way too many chances. Because they don't deserve you. You don't deserve to be treated like that. So just know that, you know, you don't deserve it. When it comes down to it, they don't deserve you. That's the bottom line. So just let them go. And then once you let them go, you're going to open yourself up to so much more positive things coming in your life. More positive people will come into your life and fill that, you know, that void that you've had for so long and stuff. It's happened for me. Like, I've had a lot of people come in my life that I just didn't expect to really come back in my life. And I'm doing way better now than what I was a year ago. So I thank those people for coming in and like basically like showing me how a real friend should be. That you shouldn't be treated as an afterthought. Just because something better comes along for somebody doesn't give them a right to drop you like a hot plate and all the plans you had. It doesn't give them a right to make up a million excuses for you to like, you know, that's just so not cool. It's not friend-like. They're not being a real true friend to you. So you guys, be you, be yourself for sure. Don't take anything like that. Like, don't give so many chances because some of these people don't deserve it. A lot of these people don't deserve it. And, you know, just kind of look out for yourself. Because who will if you don't? Who's gonna? Create some boundaries for yourself. So that people don't step on you like that. Or don't create that pattern and that behavior. Because it's not okay. You are not a second. You're not an afterthought. You're not a second thought person. You know what I'm saying? Like, you should be first choice on someone's list. You shouldn't have to beg. You shouldn't have to plead. You shouldn't have to chase after anybody. Just remember that, guys. Be yourself. The right people will find you. And you know what? Give yourself, let all that negative things go for those people. Because they're negative. They've got nothing. And they don't deserve the space. In your mind, in your heart, in your soul. You just create a peaceful world. Create a circle and let it stay small. Don't just let everybody in. Because not everybody deserves a place in your inner circle. Just remember that, guys. You guys deserve so much more. Okay, well, I've went on a rant again. Because it happens on this channel. But anyways, guys. Just remember, you are worth it. You are awesome. Stay spooktacular. Stay safe. Stay spooky. And remember to, if you haven't already, please like, comment, subscribe to my channel. We would love to have you as part of our spooky family. And remember to hit that notification bell for my newest videos. I guess for on that note, I'm going to leave as positive vibes, guys, to all of you. Hope everything goes well. Hope you guys are having an awesome, haunting, spooky, getting all your spooky stuff done that you need to do. I hope you're enjoying the spooky season like I am. And I guess also, just remember, guys, you are not an afterthought. Just positive vibes, everyone. Positive vibes. Burn some sage. Burn some lavender. Just zone out. Remember, make room for new and kick out the old that doesn't really suit you, okay? Don't ever be an afterthought or a second to someone else. Just don't. Always be yourself as well. And I'll see you next time, guys, on Jennifer's Lair. Spooky vibes and positive spooky vibes. How about that? Okay, I'll see you guys later in the next video. Talk to you later. Bye.